Welcome everyone to the Battle of Scarif. My name is Sean of the Brick Amigos, and today I'll be taking you through the epic mock collaboration between myself, Krisproductions, and Baxter Bricks. This collaboration project has been in the works since 2019. The entire layout is built on over 100 LEGO Grey base plates and features countless vehicles from talented designers. We also estimate that there are over 500,000 LEGO pieces in this build. On the tables, the mock measures out to 8 by 24 feet, which brings it to around 192 square feet. That means it is the largest LEGO Star Wars mock in Canada. We're very proud of how the Battle of Scarif turned out, and we're very excited for you to see it in this video. To complete a build of this size, the three of us needed to section off parts of the layout. So Nikko or Baxter Bricks built the front half of the mock with the Zeta cargo shuttle. I built the middle with the bunker and TIE Striker landing pads. And Kris built the back half of the layout with the menacing Scarif Tower. The tower stands almost 16 feet tall atop the tables. In some of the clips as well, you can even see Jyn Erso and Director Krennic on top of the Scarif Tower. Be sure to look out for them. One thing we really wanted to capture within Scarif was the train system that leads from each island towards the Citadel Tower. To capture this, we decided to use LEGO's elusive monorail system. Now, as most of you know, monorail is discontinued and hard to come by these days, but we were able to amass enough track and maybe even do a little bit of 3D printed track and create a cool loop that reaches from both bunkers to transport our heroes and even stormtroopers around our layout. The design of the monorail train itself follows Solo's Conveyex train, as well as elements from the Scarif train. This consideration was made to fit with LEGO's monorail scale, and we think it worked out with a nice kind of homage to both. So enjoy this minifig eye view of Scarif from the monorail. I hope you guys enjoyed that. We really like to include little Easter eggs in our builds, and I hope you guys catch some other ones throughout the video as well. So let's have a Scarif beach party. Throughout the video, you'll see custom vehicles that were designed by talented builders. We'd like to give a shout out to all of them now. AT-ATs that were turned into AT-ACTs were designed originally by Raskolnikov. The Zeta shuttle was designed by Cave God, as well as Krennic's Imperial shuttle, also by Cave God. The X-Wings, we have one designed by Jarek, also Fukusaku. We have our U-Wings, which were designed by Inther. We also have a TIE Reaper designed by Mr. Idler, and we have some TIE Strikers that were designed by LEGO, but we modified them a little bit. As Scarif is such a large layout, and the three of us live in separate cities, it does not get assembled very often. The first time it was assembled was at Brixpo 2022, and since then we have been expanding and revising and making the mock better into its final form that you see here from Brixpo 2023. We're very honored to have won Best in Show and Best in Pop Culture at Brixpo 2022 when we first displayed the mock. And of course, every project of this scale needs a time lapse of the setup. So sit back, relax, and watch as we take hours upon hours to set up Scarif. Unfortunately, this does take a long time and isn't really seen, but there is so much work that goes into just the setup of a mock like this, aside from the initial building. We also have a nice time lapse of what it kind of looks like during a display day at a show. If you've made it this far, thank you for taking a look at the Battle of Scarif. This mock has been incredible to go on this journey with, and of course I couldn't have done it without these two guys, Kris and Nikko. This has been just such a journey, and I'm really proud of what we have built here and shown for you guys. And of course our crew as well for helping set up Jesse, Taylor, and Matt, my brother. We couldn't have done this without you guys as well. Scarif has just been such an awesome journey. It was just wonderful to do this kind of collaboration with a couple other Canadians from across the prairies in another lug as well. So just really incredible. So proud to be a part of this project, and I really hope you guys enjoyed it. So thanks a lot for watching, guys. This has been the Battle of Scarif by Kris, Sean, and Nikko.